everyone, welcome to Woodstock Street. This is our high efficiency rental that is just about to go on the market. Let me show you around. So there is a ton of stuff here that we did that makes this house energy efficient, comfortable, durable. This was actually gonna be my personal house. I did something really stupid and got myself engaged. My fiance needed to live closer to work, so this is going on the rental market, and it's gonna be one of Philadelphia's most efficient rental homes, we hope. We used this house as a data collection point to figure out what things cost, what worked, what didn't, what we'd do differently. So we wanna share some of what we learned and some of our mistakes. Before we even start, I want to talk about the windows, the insulation, the air sealing package that we used. We used triple pane windows by Pella. They're not quite PassiveHaus rated, but they have a super high R value. They insulate very well. And what's really important for the city and when you're on, you know, busier streets, even though we're on a side street, these are really quiet. You can barely hear the neighbors outside. You can't hear when cars drive by. They're super high performance windows and they cost about $400 more than a traditional double pane window. We have six on the front, six on the back. The window package for this house, including the exterior patio doors, cost about $13,000. We self-installed everything. We wanted to make sure the details were perfect, they were foamed right, and really happy with the way they look and came out. They get a lot of compliments. Behind the walls, we have RockWool mineral wool insulation. We also have an Intello air barrier. It's a one-way intelligent vapor barrier. It lets moisture dry to the interior. Also, around every outlet, we have a LESSCO box. It's a way to seal around the boxes to make them airtight. It's a green plastic box that we caulk the wires into. A lot of times in older drafty houses, especially renovations, you can put your hand to an outlet or a light switch and feel a draft. That doesn't exist with these. We'll post some links to the profile to the products that we used. It's also worth noting that we installed blocking wherever we needed to, where we thought a TV might go. We consciously lost some living room space in favor of a vestibule. We think it's kind of super intrusive when you open the front door and you're immediately in someone's living room. This provides an air break. It keeps conditioned air from leaving the space. And it also adds a little bit of privacy and noise reduction. Gives us a place for coat hooks, and it's kind of a clean way to separate the outside from the inside. The whole house runs on minisplits, which we are conditioning our tenants and potential tenants to see as an upgrade, essentially. Everyone's used to seeing central air. It's one ducted unit, usually lives in a basement or a closet, and it's really unfair to ask those units to condition a three-story house properly. I've never been in a single-zone HVAC system in a three-story home that's been properly conditioned on the third floor in the summer, that wasn't sweltering hot, or also stuffy in the wintertime. These let us control each room individually, according to preference, according to use, according to occupancy. We're really gonna save a lot of money on the energy bills by using these. It's also worth noting that it's in the middle of winter in Philadelphia. We only have this one unit on, and it's keeping the entire house warm. It's really cool to see, and we're really gonna, you know, hopefully see lower energy bills because of that. So this is an exterior grade door that we used for the entrance into the basement. The basement is unconditioned, so we're treating this as an exterior door. This is insulated, it has weather stripping around it to prevent any air leakage, and it also has a lock on it. So if anyone breaks in the basement window, or if your kids are misbehaving and you need some time away from them, that's where they can stay for a little bit. Don't do that. So we're in the kitchen right now and we went all electric with everything. We don't like the idea of burning natural gas inside, so our stovetop is induction. We did this mostly for indoor air quality purposes and also so that we could eliminate gas from the house. In 1992, they banned pilot lights on residential appliances because it's A, inefficient, and B, there's so many illnesses and conditions associated with burning natural gas inside. Again, indoor air quality is super important for us. I'll post some links to articles, but the EPA did studies about burning natural gas inside, and essentially air quality with a stove and no ventilation was so bad that if it was outside, it would be illegal. There's just not legislation or regulation that dictates the indoor air quality regulations for inside your house. So, you know, you'll never find us doing a recirculating micro hood above a gas appliance. We're always gonna vent to the outside or use electric. In this case, we have a top of the line Z-line black stainless steel recirculating vent hood. We chose not to duct to the outside because of the HRV system that we have. We'll talk about that in a little bit, but we have a return for our HRV system here. But also inside of here are activated charcoal filters to get rid of cooking odor, and that's part of our maintenance plan for this house. We replace that with activated charcoal that we get on everyone's favorite Amazon. The oven is all electric as well. If we were to do this again, we would use a slide-in unit where it is an oven and a cooktop all in one. This was a lot of carpentry involved in this, two electrical circuits, and spatially it took a lot of, you know, coordinating. We actually messed up the layout of the kitchen a little. We forgot about one of the doors, so we had to do a little hack for the cabinet. Well, we measured everything, but not the handle for the oven, so. Thought that was pretty clever. One of the most important things that we did for this property, since we're gonna be marketing this to renters and we don't actually get to talk to them, we put all the information onto a double-sided handout to talk about, you know, what our values are in this house and what's important. There is so much stuff that gets lost in translation with your realtors, with your tenants, with other realtors marketing in the house, that we wanted to make sure we control the narrative. And we put a lot of time and money into making this an energy efficient and comfortable and durable house. And we wanted to make sure that, you know, we had a fair shot of talking to everyone about it. These cabinets are reclaimed from a kitchen that we did in West Mount Airy. They're wood. We actually repainted them, which was a pain in the butt. We're not gonna do again. So this is a double pane insulated door by Pella. It is super energy efficient. It's got a great air sealing package around it. The backyard, there was a 6-foot CMU or concrete masonry unit wall that was in pretty good shape. It's pretty ugly. And also we can't go higher than 6 feet for a fence without a special variance. So what we did, we built a little planter around there and we dug up some bamboo from a different project we were on. So we planted this about 6 months ago and it's already taking over. In about 2 years, we're hoping it's gonna be 30 feet high. You'll be able to see it from the second floor. You'll look out the kitchen windows and see a wall of green. And that's what we're going for, the privacy and the rustling. We like bamboo. Let's go up to the second floor. Have you learned your lesson, Terry?
Yeah, I've learned it.
And?
I won't leave tools on top of the ladder anymore.
Go think about what you did.
I know.
Security door really comes in handy. This is technically a bedroom, but most likely it's gonna be used as an office. It's pretty small. We actually gained another 2 feet of width. We were able to build out to the neighboring property and connect to that party wall. But we ended up using this closet as a mechanical room. Our thought process was getting the hot water heater closer to the fixtures. It's right next to a shower. It's right above the kitchen. It's 15 feet away from the wash. It's actually 12 feet away from the washer and dryer. And it's 5 feet away from the shower right above it. So all the hot water usage is within a really short distance of here. So that minimizes the consumption, but we ended up losing a closet and making this bedroom not as optimal as it could have been. That being said, it's a lesson that we learned and we took the opportunity to use this as a mechanical closet. We have the manifold here for the PEX system. And we also have the whole house ventilation system. So what we do is we pull air from both bathrooms and the kitchen, and that stale air, it has odors, it has moisture, it has steam in it. That goes to the outside. Simultaneously, we're pulling air from the outside, and there's a heat exchanger in here, so we're actually recovering some of the heat or cooling depending on the season and tempering that filtered air that goes back into the house. And again, we're really focused on indoor air quality. This room has another minisplit system, which it allows us to keep this off or on depending on if we're using it. And again, our hope is in a couple years that this bamboo will grow another 10 or 15 feet and you'll be able to see it out this window. Bamboo is an incredibly sustainable building product. It's slowly becoming adopted in the United States. It's used in a lot of other places in the world. The floors are all laminate bamboo hardwood. It was really important for us to have our laundry in a centrally located place. We put a laundry room instead of a linen closet on the second floor. We are using a top-of-the-line Miel heat pump dryer and the stacked washer kit for it. This cost about $3,000. We could have gotten a Bosch heat pump system for closer to $2,300. Again, this was gonna be a personal house. We figured we might as well not skimp on it. What this allows us to do, we're able to use a 20 amp circuit for this dryer. So we don't need any gas lines run to it. We don't need any specialized electric lines run to it. The 20 amp circuit that we would have for controls of a dryer is there. And we importantly don't need to duct this out to the exterior. This is a condensing dryer. All the water gets condensed into this kind of cool little cartridge, and then we're able to dump it right in the sink when we're done. It's a nice feature to have a little laundry sink in here for stains, for utility, for, you know, washing your hands. I like line drying stuff, so we got this wall-mounted clothes rack on Amazon. I'll post another link to that as well. Put a couple hooks in for brooms. There is a flood pan that goes into an indirect drain in the basement. God forbid anything were ever to malfunction. If we were to do it again, we would be a little more discreet about the drain line, but that being said, it's a laundry room. We have another bedroom here. We really like using ceiling fans and keeping the windows open. We made sure to spec that when we ordered the windows, that the screens be delivered. We store them in the basement. We store them off-site during construction because they almost always get damaged by one trade or another. You know, eventually our goal is to, you know, leave the window cracked. Ceiling fan is on a timer. Otherwise, we have a small heat pump mini-split wall cassette here, which will keep this room individually tempered. We pre-wired the house for power for a TV, as well as Cat 6 and coaxial lines as well. Lights are on a dimmer. Our electrician is a total pro and cares about quality. He uses Lutron dimmers. They're really good. Bathroom is a bathroom. We had some fun with the tile. We did some cool colors. Everything's gonna be cleaned by a third-party service before the tenants move in. One of the things that we did differently in this bathroom, since we're using heat pump mini splits, for about $400 more, we installed a radiant heat floor system in here. In the summer, tiled rooms typically don't get that hot. Also, we have such a great insulation package. We also have a return for HRV in such a well-sealed house that it's pulling air from the rest of the house. So we're not worried about it being too outside of the comfort zone. Heated floor is on a programmable thermostat. You can set it and turn it on. So in the winter at 6 a.m. it'll turn on, at 9 a.m. it'll turn off, so you can wake up with warm floors. Yeah, we're gonna take you up to the third floor. Terry's gonna show you some of the stuff that we did there. Let's go see.
This house is Sasha's baby. He's been working on it for 2-3 years. What is it now?
Oh, how's it going, guys? I didn't see you there. I was thinking about how much money I spent on things that are almost impossible to recoup for rent.
This floor is the main bedroom. There's a door at the bottom of the steps that creates privacy. We've got mini split in the room. We've got a ceiling fan. It really is. It's unlike any other bedroom that you're gonna find in this neighborhood. We've got a walk-in closet right here. It's got a beautiful granite countertop. It's got tons of storage space for all your clothes. And one of our biggest mistakes was where we put the light switch. In hindsight, we would have put the light switch here because you're gonna be storing things here, whether it's shoes or something, and it's gonna be in the way of the light switch. If it was on this side, there's nothing gonna be in the way. You know, it's intuitive when you walk in the door, the side it opens from, you're gonna wanna reach around and touch that light switch. You live and you learn. And here's the main bathroom on the third floor. I love the black and white theme that we've got going on in here. We've got this beautiful granite countertop on the vanity. We've got this fun tile on the floor, the fun tile in the shower. We've got this beautiful glass divider. You know, another, that leads me to one of our other mistakes. we didn't really think about this in the design phase. In order to turn the shower on, you kind of have to get in the shower. So you're likely going to get hit with a little bit of cold water. It's not the end of the world, but if we could redo it, we would put it on this side. And one of the coolest parts of the house is the gravity film heat exchanger. So when you're taking a hot shower, all that hot water is running down the drain. It's essentially going to waste. What the gravity film heat exchanger does is it allows the water that's being fed to the water heater to be preheated before it goes in. So that means the water temperature going into the bottom of the water heater is higher than the tap water. You know, tap water during the winter is around 50 degrees. When the hot water from the shower is running, it heats it up to a nice 80 degrees, 90 degrees. It makes a difference, and it's another energy saver. And then right here, we've got the door to the roof deck. If you come on out here, you can see we've got a nice spiral staircase up to the top. This is the condenser for all the mini splits. We've got this beautiful rooftop up here, you know, perfect for gatherings in the summer, you know, when it's not too hot out. It does get too hot in the city. And then you walk over to this side and you get this unbelievable view of the skyline. I know I've taken too much time up here just staring at that view. I can't help it. So we're gonna head on down into the basement. I know Sasha already talked a little bit about this door, but it really is secure. One of the reasons that we did that is because we've got these two windows down here. You know, if someone was to try to break in, likely they would try to kick in one of those windows. And if you have the ability to lock that door, it prevents them from getting upstairs, which is an added reassurance. So as you can see, the walls are all white. What it is a lime wash. And so if I rub my hand on it, you can kind of see it comes off a little bit. And the reason we use lime wash is it allows vapors to move through. We don't want to create a vapor seal on this stone here because then that would trap moisture in. When you're trying to stop a leak from the outside, you don't ever want to do it from the inside because then you're just going to trap moisture in the wall and it's going to lead to more issues down the road. Another cool thing we have down here is we added a spigot right here and fed a little water line through the exterior wall so that the rose on the outside could be set on a timer and get watered automatically. Since this is an all electric house, we were able to get rid of the gas line coming in. And so the gas company actually came in and cut off the line and added this to seal it. And then they came in at a later point. You can see out front, there's a part of the concrete that's been torn up and redone. And it's because they actually dug down into the ground and cut out the connection from the main gas supply to the house. So this house is completely disconnected from the gas supply. All these lines right here are the condensate lines from the mini splits. So anytime you have a heater or AC unit, moisture is gonna condense and it's gonna wanna go somewhere. They're all fed into this indirect drain right here. And that goes into the main drain line that goes out into the rest of the system. Other than that, we didn't do a whole lot down here. You know, we painted the floor to seal it up, give it a nice clean look. And we had some leftover cabinets from the cabinets that we installed in the kitchen. And we just put them down here for storage. You know, there's a nice little nook under the stairs where we are storing some leftover paints from the project. We've got the screens down here to keep them out of harm's way.
So if you're still following along, we hope you enjoyed what you saw. It means you like building houses almost as much as we do. Be sure to subscribe and toss a couple comments or likes our way. It truly means a lot to us. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the next project.